Hello students, welcome to my channel. Today I'm going to deal with a revision session for your second PUC subject economics. In this revision session we'll discuss about very important questions, that is both the 4 marks and 6 marks type questions. Then let me discuss chapter wise one by one questions. First we will discuss those 4 marks questions from the part A section. As you know that in your second PUC there are 2 sections, part A microeconomics and also part B macroeconomics. So each section will contain its own importance and the weightage of marks, that is we can observe in the each sections. Okay students, then now let me discuss about what are the important 4 marks questions and how to write the answers for those questions with elaborately discuss in this session. First question, briefly explain how the family farm, weaver and teacher can use their resources to fulfill their needs in a simple economy. First, you need to try to understand the meaning of question. What is the meaning of this question? That means in a simple economy, as you know that the features of simple economy. Right? So in a simple economy, how the family farms, means farmer and also weaver and teacher, they will live by using their resources. So for this question we need to answer like this. People in the society need many goods and services in their life. For example, the purpose like a food, clothing, shelter, transport facilities, postal services and other many services. So these services which required, even though what all kind of people like teachers, doctors, lawyers, farmers, weavers, etc. So every individual has some amount of only a few of the goods and services that he would like to use. In such cases, we can say that a family farm. Yes, a family farmer, he may own a plot of land with some what grains, farming implements, that is maybe a pair of bullocks and also labor services from his family members. So that is what the resources used by the farmer. Now with the help of this what resources, a family farmer, he can produce corn and use of the part of the produce for the consumption purpose, and produce and remaining he can use for the clothing, housing and various services in exchange for the rest of the produce. That means farmer, he can produce what some amount of crops like corn or whatever, in that by using the what resources like above, resources like land, some grains, farming implements, and with the help of his family members he can produce a corn. Yes, now in this corn he can consume for self purpose and also some amount of what the consumption or some amount of production he is ready to sell in the market. Why? Because to clothing purpose, his own needs like housing purpose and also various other services. So in this way farmer, he can fulfill his desires or the needs. Like that, a weaver, he may have some yarn, some cotton, and other instruments which is required for weaving the clothes. So these are the resources used by the weaver. Okay, now how he fulfill his needs by using these resources? So now the weaver can get the goods and services that she wants in exchange for the cloth she produces in her yarn. That means weaver can use the resources like yarn, cotton, and other instruments. By the help of that, he can produce the clothes, okay? And in that clothes, he is exchanged in the market and he will earn some amount of money. So in that, he can fulfill his life. Even though third one, teacher. Teacher in the local school has the skills required to impart education to the students. Some others in society may not have any resources excepting their own labor services. That means, so teacher's resource is nothing but her own skill, that is for imparting the education to the students, right? By the help of that skill, she can earn some amount of money. Yes? So, in that, she earns some money by teaching the students in the school and use that money for obtaining the goods and services that she wants. That means, teacher can earn money by the help of her skill by imparting the knowledge to the students, and with those money she can use or she can buy goods and services whatever she require. Yes, so this is for the teacher services. Thus we can say that each individual can use his own resources to fulfill his needs, like farmer, weaver, and also teacher. And it is said that no individual has unlimited resources compared to his needs. That means his needs are unlimited, but the availability of resources are very limited. Means wants are unlimited, but the availability of resources very limited. Okay, thus the quantity of corn that the family farm can produce is limited by the quantity of resources it has. And hence, the amount of different goods and services that it can procure in exchange of corn is also limited. As a result, family is forced to make a choice between the different goods and services that are available in the society. Like that only weaver and teacher. Okay, so this is what we can say that what the different individuals, they can use their resources and they will fulfill their desires or the needs in the simple economy. Next, we'll discuss about second question. Write a note on market economy. Means regarding the market economy, we need to write some explanation. This is what the 4 marks question. Then let me discuss about market economy. So then let me discuss about market economy. As you know that students, in a economic system, we have to classify it into 3 ways. One is centrally planned economy. Second one is market economy. And third one is mixed economy. Yes, as you know the features of a centrally planned economy and other 2 type of economic system. So centrally planned economy, we know that already the decisions making, control, as well as managed everything that is under the what government itself. And the sole motive is to earn not a profit but to what welfare of the individual or welfare of the society. This is what the centrally planned economy.
So like that market economy. So under the market economy here, we can say that what the ownership, decision, management, control, that is all under market mechanism. So market economy is nothing but here whole economy which is controlled, managed, owned by the what market mechanism. And also we can say that consumers played a major role in the market economy, and the consumer sovereignty played a major role, because consumers can get whatever the demand, the goods and services in such type of market economy. Thus, we can say that under the market economy, here it is individual welfare is recognized, not a what whole welfare of the society. And there are three problems, as you know, that what to produce, there are three problems in the society, that is what to produce, how to produce, and for whom to produce. These three problems are also solved under the market economy by its own way. That we can say that for what, that is what to produce. In this case, the firm or the economy which can produce those goods and services which are highly demand in the society. It is not matter like the least price product or basic needs product, not like that. Even in the society, so which goods and services are highly demand, such type of commodities, for such type of goods and services produced in the market. And how to produce. So most of the market economy here, which we can say that the goods and services which can be produced by the technique of a capital intensive. As you know that there are two types of techniques, labor intensive technology and capital intensive technology. Here under the market economy, for the purpose of more production, we can use what the capital intensive technology or machineries, tools in the production of goods and services. And for whom to produce, this problem is solved by the economy, that is by supplying the goods and services those who required what the products very urgently. That means those people, they are not under like poor people, they are rich in the society. They are rich in the society and they will demand the goods and services, and the economy will produce the goods and services. In this way, these three problems are also solved under the market economy. Okay, students, so this is for the market economy. In the next class, we'll discuss further four marks questions. Until that, you need to practice these questions. We'll see in tomorrow's episode. Thank you.